Alright, this is going to be the part 5 of how to make an elevator animation. Now, as we made sure we already got these in order, start with the impulse call button. I use my mouth of how to make that elevator button noise, and see that arrow pointing right there? That is the right button. You touch the screen and then click the right button at the same time. You see where my mouse is? Where the hand of my mouse, just click right, and that goes in order. See, that's how I did it. And it's something really hard, that it's really hard to get this thing in the camera frame with my hand on the mouse, clicking the right button, and touching the screen. So I might have to show you that maybe later, because I'll have to find some good ways of how to do that. But right now, we're going to get focused on this elevator animation part. So what we're going to do first is, we already got the doors opening done. Oh, the first is the elevator button. Oh, I mean, I mixed up. The first, you draw the elevator doors, and then the second, you draw the button, you call the elevator, and then third, you draw the door movements. You draw the cab, and then fourth, you draw the door movements, just like I showed you. Just watch it on part 3, and I'll show you how I did the doors. And now, I forgot the parts again. Part 1 is the elevator, and part 2 is the button. Part 3 is, what's part 3? Let me think. Part 1, we got the elevator doors. Part 2, the button. I think part 3 is, I think I forgot. Hold on, let me go back to my YouTube channel. I'm going to see what is part 3. Because I forgot. Let's go back to my channel, see what part 3 is. Alright, come on. Alright, there we go. Oh, here's part 3 right here. Oh, drawing the elevator cab. So part 3 is drawing the elevator cab, and part 4 is drawing the door movements. Now, I'm on part 5. There are two things for part 5. Light up the bell indicator. So this is how you light up the indicator. We all know it's up, so we're going to point it up. So I'm going to move the camera towards the screen so you can see, and here it is. Alright, now you got the indicator. Now you save it. Type in 11. You either push save or you can press enter. And then you're saved, and the next thing now for part 5 is drawing the inside elevator button panel. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to copy the impulse button. See, this is the impulse button. Now you copy, then go to a new page, and you paste it, and here's the Dover impulse button. So what we're gonna do now is we're gonna draw the keypad for impulse, just like on a Dover elevator. And like I said, this is going to be equivalent to diesel deuce, like the one in the Market parking garage in Roanoke, Virginia. Alright, now I have to get rid of that, because that is where the braille goes. See, this is going to be for door open. Door open, door closed, 1, 2, 3, etc. Dover impulse keypad just looks like this. Hold on, let me make a small rectangle here. Gotta smarten that a little bit. There we go. Color it dark gray. You copy and paste. And here's another Dover Impulse button. This is going to be for 1, 2, 3, and 4. I'll make it to seven stories. Copy and paste this one. And there's the buttons for 1, 2, 3, and 4. Let's make sure I get it right. Let me undo that. Repaste it. Hopefully I don't smaller that thing up. There we go. Now this is for 1, 2, 3, and 4. Now what we're going to do is, for a keypad, we have to draw this. Yeah, I can't see very well. There we go. Now I got it to start. I got a better way. We'll just copy and paste it, because that can be the easiest way. Oh. Sorry about that, everyone. That was my mom. So anyways, I already copy and paste it. Now we drag it and stick it right there. And there's that line. I do not know what that line is for, but this is not custom impulse. This is just regular impulse elevator. An impulse Dover elevator. And here it is. That's what it looks like. And this is going to be 5, 6, and 7. But we have to get rid of that because that is not a floor. It can't be 8 stories. And we're doing this 7 stories, because that is what the market parking garage is. 7 story hydraulic. Now this is how an impulse Dover elevator looks like. We're going to color that. And these are your impulse buttons. So what we're going to do is I'm going to get rid of that, because that is not a floor. Now this is going to be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. But, except, the elevator numbering is different because that says G and then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. That's a pretty interesting number layout. Oh, I gotta bigger this a little bit. Let me do a little bit more. One more bit. And I guess there you go. There's your Dover impulse button. Let me make another one of these. And then we're going to do the door open and door close buttons. Alright, now we're going to do the door open and door close. Oh, let me do this. I didn't do this right. Oops. Yeah, I did this wrong. I guess I'll be okay doing like this way. Now, we're going to do the door open and door close. Now we're going to get rid of that because that is where the keyhole goes. Here's a keyhole. Copy and paste. Close that. And that is going to be the, for instead of on and off, I'm going to put run and stop. So what I'm going to do is I'll get rid of that either by erasing it or coloring over it. So, what the heck? Wait a minute. I don't think I did this right. Well, I'll just leave it like that, just for now. Well, I'll have to, I'm gonna have to fix that later. Right now, let's just get into this. See, this is gonna be for door open, this is gonna be for door close, that's alarm, and this is gonna be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Well, I'm not gonna do it just like what, well, I might do it just, almost as equivalent. Well, no, I'm not. For my opinion, I'm just gonna put 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. And then up here, what I'm gonna put are the keyholes. So, let me make another one of these. Copy and paste. Yeah, I'm still gonna have that. I'm still gonna have that little mistake, but that's all right. Oops, gotta add this. Now, these are going to be the keyholes, and up here will be the call cancel and fire controls. Actually, no, I'll just put it right here, and I think that will be it for now. You know, let me make another square over here just for a phone, like this. And I have an easier way to do this, right? You just make another, you just make a door for the phone. See, that's the phone door right there. See, down there is the phone box. And then you stick it over here. And there's your phone down there. I'm thinking it's going to be ADA compliant. Now, I'm going to have to get rid of that because those are key switches. Actually, no, I'm going to leave the call cancel up there. And let me move that. Let me move that over here. Here we go. Wait, I didn't do it wrong. Let me zoom in so we could see. There we go. Zooming in must be very easier to see. I'm gonna move it over here. I hope you're seeing this, and I hope the camera's cooperating. Now, this is going to be the fireman's hat, so let's get rid of that impulse button there. And I'm gonna draw a fireman hat. Let me go down a little. And here is the fireman's hat. I kind of can't draw that good, but let me fix it just a little bit. This is how it looks like. The fireman's hat. Yeah, I didn't draw that great at all. I'm sorry about that, folks. And it was almost there, but I think that looks just fine. See, there's the fireman's hat. Now I gotta put a fire key switch right there. Very dark gray. Color that. And, oop, got one line missing right there. There we go. Now we got the fireman's hat, and that background thing should be colored red because that, we all know that's fire, and right there, that is the call cancel button. Oopsies, colored the wrong one. Ah, this sucks. Can't do it. I have to zoom in. Sorry about that. There we go. Yeah, this mouse is kind of stupid. And there is that call cancel, and I have to get rid of that and put the keyholes there. I got a better idea. Yeah, I'm not doing this right at all. There we go. Now, here are the buttons. And let me add the keyhole there. So that is pointed right there. I guess that looks okay, even though that was kind of open. But I don't have to worry about it. But what I can do is I'll just trace it like this. And same down here. Got a little opening. I'll just close it like this. And there you go. Now here is the fire service key. And that should be turned to off. Because off goes here and fire goes up here. And hold goes right here. Now the key is turned to the off. See, that's the off section right here, and there's the on section. Wait a minute. Why am I kept saying on? That's fire, and that is hold, just like on most elevators here. And we'll put some more keyholes right there. And why is my camera does not want to focus as I point my hand over there? See, this key is going to be for the independent service mode. This key right here is going to be the fan, and this key right here will be the light. And now the next part is we're going to be adding the numbers and the symbols. So I'm not going to have to waste a lot of memory. So we're going to copy and paste. This one is for the independent service mode. Get rid of that. And the second thing is the fan. And this right here is the light. Now the light should be on the on section. We all know the light is always turned on. Yeah, I kind of messed up right there, but that's okay. 90 degrees, that's on. And fan. I'm not sure if I could turn it to on or off. But I'll turn it to off, I guess. When I hear the fan turning on, when I try to get the sounds, I'll try to turn the fan back on if I hear the fan noise. So I'll just do off for now. And this independent service thing, I guess we'll turn it to 80 degrees, turn to group. See, independent service goes up here and group goes down here. Just like I heard on most elevators, but I'm not really sure what group means. But if anybody knows, just leave a comment below. 180 degrees. I guess that's good. So there you have it. The elevator buttons. Oh, by the way, I gotta add the lines. I gotta add this so we all know that's Dover. Dover Impulse. There you go. Now we'll zoom in and color it gray. Oh, I gotta add that. Oh, I forgot. Yeah, let me bigger this up a little bit. Let me add this. Let me flip vertically. Now we'll stick it on. And there it is. There's the Dover Impulse button. And I'll make a little line here. Because that's what I see on most Dover elevators. And I'll make one more on the right. By copying this. Go to the right. And there you have it. The Dover Impulse interior panel. I still haven't turned on that push button noises yet, but there it is. So, I'm going to save it for now. I'm going to select 12. Now, we're going to play it. And we got the Dover Impulse button. That is done. Now the elevator doors. And the opening. Yeah, this computer is kind of acting weird. It just kind of blinks. I don't know why. This computer kind of glitches a little bit. Now, we got the indicator. I should have done that on the inside, but that's okay. I'll do it whatever, but when I do it on the inside, it's just the exact same. And the easiest way, if you want to do an impulse lantern, just draw like a square for up and then down, and then you make a vertical rectangle. Now here are the Dover impulse buttons. I haven't selected any numbers, but I've already turned on that noise. Door open, alarm, door close, call cancel, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. See, now we got the impulse buttons. So there it is. So I guess that'll conclude it all. That's it for today. So, that's it.